Te whakakoi noaiho I ngā pukena I runga me waho o te papatākaro, te mahi e toi ana I te kura whakanunu toa nei o Irans, I mua I te tākaro whakamutuna ki te tīma o Wairarapa Bush. Kua tonoa ko te kaiako pukena o ngā opango a Mick Byrne, hei whakatikatika, hei tāpiri atu ki ngā mōhiotana o ngā kaitākaro. Mai I ana mahi I ngā taumata teitei o te hutupōro a Hitreiria, te riki me te hutupōro, kua whakairohia e Mick he āhuatana e tāi ai, te whakapaiake I te tākaro, mā ngā āhuatana taketake e ki ana ko ngā biomechanics. Kua ia tērā ko te āta whakamahi tika I te neke o te tinana, kia tika ai te puta mai o ōkaha.
Okay, the first thing we're going to work on this morning is we're going to work on understanding how we become more powerful in our kick. Just on a quick observation, if your kick looks something like back from here, back there, all right, if that's what you think your kick looks like, then we're going to work from there. Finding power in our body works on all areas of our skill, as we talked about. So if I just got you to come out now, we're going to do a little, quick little demo. All right, you're going to put that ball down for a sec. You're going to tackle me. All right, and I'm going to try and get past you. All right? You ready? Okay, make sure you get me. What's he done? What's his movement? You want to smash me, don't you? Good man. All right, what did he first do? Well, that's the first thing he did when he thought, I'm going to smash this bloke. What did he do? Got himself in what he felt was a powerful position. Is that fair, Cole? That's the first thing we're looking at is our ability to bring that powerful position into our kick. Once we do that, we've got to understand we're powerful there. All right. Now, when we get into that position where our foot is planted out in front of us and we're back here, that's not powerful. The biggest area we're going to work on this morning is understanding that contact area, because that's the biggest change we probably have to make to our kicking action.
I think if a young player can understand the components of a skill, they'll find their own way through those principles. If we look at a golf swing, the top 10 golfers in the world step up onto a golf tee, there's not one swing that's exactly like the other, but their outcomes are all fairly similar. So there's principles being met, but each golfer has his sort of own comfortable way of getting through those principles. And I think that's our challenge with our younger players, is to help them understand what are the principles of a skill, and to break it down to as least number of components that are effective, and then allow them to find their own way of getting through there.
What I want you to do is just pick up that rock that's beside you on the ground. Don't look too hard because it's probably not there, but just pick it up anyway. Pick it up. I want you to throw it through that goal. Throw it. Go on. That went about there, that one. I want it to go through the goal. What's happening? What's the movement we're getting between our elbow and our hand? Yep, we're getting a spring, flick, snap, we're getting that movement. All right, we have to replicate that movement in our kick. And the only way we can do it, let's go to just a little example. For those of you that are right footers, just stick your left foot out in front of you. If you're left footer, stick your right foot out in front of you. Lean on your back leg. So your chest is back behind your foot. Now I want you to bend your knee. What do you feel like's going to happen to you? Fall over. So what tends to happen when we kick in that position, we kick with a straight leg. Fair call? All right, now I want you to throw that rock with a straight arm. How powerful do you feel? Hey? Not really powerful. So we need to make sure that we can bring that power in. So the first thing we do is we understand that power, then if you stand up now over your plant foot, you're pretty good now, flick your leg down. Bend your knee and flick it down. We can do that from there, can't we?
Tino, pai ana ngā akonga, ngā mahi o McBurn. Ona akonga he tino pai ana ki a mātou ngā eki ngā paumua. Mo te whanaporo, ngā taukua heke ko ngā backs anake e akonga hi a rātou hunga mea. Engari, ko mātou ngā paumua e ako hoki.
Okay, let's get yourself in pairs. Work from the 10-metre line down to the try line in your pairs.
So he was good, eh?
One pair on the 10-metre line.
He did a lot on the kicking and things like that, so little things just like snapping your foot and explaining how to get the power out of it and stuff like that, just little things you wouldn't think of. And automatically, like, along our whole line of boys that were lined up doing the kicking, you just hear the boys in amazement, like, you know, stoked that the kick's just improved over 5 minutes.
Okay, what we want to look at here is, as you're kicking this, I want you to tell me if you're feeling your leg swinging or you're just feeling that leg just snapping down. Good.
Paerawatu ngā rā whakatā.
How'd you feel there?
I haere mātou ki River Valley. Tino paerawatu. Hari ko te ngāka i haere au. Ngā mahi ngā inanahi. Te taho o McBurn. He tangata tino koia ki te pane i te poro. Pai ngā mahinga.
Okay.
Kia tai a koe i te pana poro. Tino pai. I kia te kau miniti i a rā. Mo te rua te kau mawhitu. Rā, paerawatu o pana i te pōro, ahakoa, kore koe tāe ki te pana, i muri i tēnā mainga, tino paerawatu ki ia.
Abs, how many of us started to feel our abs a little bit? Okay, and that's what we're doing. We're finding muscles to stabilise. How many guys before today, when you kicked the ball, felt sore on your abs? Okay, great, because what we've done there is we've transferred some muscle memory into our abs. Our challenge is we have to keep that there because it hurts a little bit and that memory is not good. And so it doesn't want to stay there. It wants to go back to the old way where it didn't hurt. So we need to challenge ourselves there. That little activity is all you need to do in the next couple of weeks to improve your kicking. That's all you have to do.
Mahi tahi ai a Mick me nā kaitākoro toa i nā wā katoa, me tōna mōhio anō hoki ki te rerekētanga mai te kaitākoro pai me te kaitākoro toa.
We've got very accomplished players out here. They're certainly at the accomplished stage, and quite possibly, potentially, there's a couple of elite players there. What I'm looking at there as an elite player is basically their ability to perform the skill under pressure and fatigue and at greater pace, while maintaining an accuracy in their outcome.
Ahakoa e mōhiotia ana tōna ingoa ko Mick the Kick, tino mātou anō ia ki te pāpāhi i te pōro.
So what am I actually doing when I pass like that? Yeah, but what am I actually doing? I'm putting what on the ball? Yeah, and where's all my energy going into? Yeah. So what I want to do is we want to create a pass that goes that way. So what I'm doing is I push it and I get rotation at the end on release. Again, normally, because my hand's at the side and when I point to my target, I normally just roll my hand. That's all I get. That's all I need to do. So the big key that's missing in our passing action is that power we talked about this morning. It's the same as the spiral kick. Don't worry about creating spin. The spin will take care of itself. Create power. Push. The spin will always take care of itself.
Ko hoki anō ki roto i te rūma ako, o te tohunga pāpāho a Tony Johnson kei te whakahaere i tēnei wāhanga. Mai tōna whakauruna ki te kura nei ko te wāhanga a Tony Johnson mo te pāpāho, tētahi o nā akorana e tino pīrangi hiāna.
I suppose when you looked at the schedule for the couple of weeks that you're going to be here, you thought, well, what's that got to do with being a rugby player? Why do I need media skills? But the fact is, in this day and age, you guys are all here because you've been seen as potential professional rugby players, and being able to deal with the media and conduct yourself accordingly in public, it's all part and parcel of being a professional rugby player these days. We'll get you to do some role playing, we'll get some of you to pretend you're Tana Umanga and what have you, and the rest of you can interview each other. I think there's a greater awareness these days of the whole media requirement. I think players accept that it is part and parcel of the job of being a professional rugby player. I think these days where you see a lot more of the players on TV, like when I was growing up, you hardly ever saw the All Blacks. These days you see them all the time, and so they look at them, they see how they portray themselves and the need for them to portray themselves positively, and I think they take their lead from that, and the results are encouraging. Media, very important part in the rugby game these days. Why? Pays the bills. It's also the main way that people watch the game. So how you conduct yourself is very important. And the bridge, I think, between you guys and the public who follow the game is the media.
Ka tukuna he kaupapa rereke ki i aropu. Ka mutu he kaupapa tūturu enei. Ma rātou e whakatautau mai i nā kai patapatai me nā kai whakautu.
Even some of the current All Blacks, I can remember when they started, they had no media training, they weren't prepared for it at all. I think things have changed, and guys coming in now, they're, you know, fairly well schooled up in what the requirements are. And I think, you know, one of the benefits of this is that you're giving a lot of these guys a first taste of it, probably ahead of a lot of other players of their age group, so that by the time these guys start getting into rep teams with a bit of a profile, they'll at least have some idea of what's expected of them.
I think you guys want to go first, huh?
Yeah.
This is something that happened a few years ago. Chiefs played the Blues in Hamilton. 14 minutes into the game, Troy Flavel got sent off for putting the boot into one of the Chiefs players. So obviously, after the game, two things. Firstly, the fact that they've won the game with 14 players, thanks in no small way to the efforts of Rupeni. But secondly, the incident. You're going to get asked about it, so how do you handle that? You know, you give your teammate a hard time, do you judge him before he's been before the judiciary, or what sort of messages do you send out to the public? So that's the scenario. We've got Xavier Rush here. Okay.
What was running through your mind in the 40th minute when Troy Flavel was recast?
Well, we knew it was going to be an uphill battle from then on, and that everyone was going to have to dig in deep. All the boys came out, we had a huddle. He said everyone's going to have to put everything on the line the whole game. And we did. Everyone was pretty amazing the way we played, I thought. So
this one here, guys, this is after the first test against the Lions a couple of years ago. You'll remember the incident where Brian O'Driscoll got upended, some people say spear-tackled, shoulder out of the tour, and you remember the big fuss after. So we have here, minus the dreadlocks, Tana Umanga facing the press 2 days later, and obviously you got some angry people in there from the English press.
Hey Tana, as we all know, that tackle you pulled on O'Driscoll earlier in the test match was dangerous, but was it deliberate?
Oh, I don't feel it was dangerous, and not at all was it intentional, man. This Lions tour has been built up to be one of the biggest tours to date. And so, obviously, I was going to be pumped up and a lot of aggression out there, but by no means was that incident on O'Driscoll not intentional at all. There was no malice in it. I'm out there to play the game, not to go and injure people.
Charlie's been named as captain of the New Zealand Māori side that are going to the Churchill Cup in Canada. So, you know, thoughts on that, carrying on the great and very important tradition of Māori rugby.
What was your reaction when asked to captain the side?
Oh, I was surprised, but honoured to captain the side. It's been been a great legacy of captains that led this team to great victories, and it's just a privilege to carry that tradition on.
Being defending champions, do you feel much pressure?
Always a lot of pressure when putting that black jersey on, but those are the things you just gotta put behind you and fix on your game.
We heard a rumor about the late Fokker incident. Is it real?
As a team, we started on some rules and guidelines, and Robert decided to break that agreement, so as a team, we decided to drop them.
How's that going to affect your team?
Robbie, he's a great player, but I think we had the depth in our squad to cover his absence.
Just remember, when you're speaking, it's not just about you, it's about your team, it's about the game. Always take that as an opportunity to show yourself, show your team in a good light. Thank you for the way you have applied yourself to this exercise this morning. I know it's probably out of the ordinary, probably something that you weren't expecting it, but I appreciate the fact that you went away and you diligently applied yourself to this, and I think you've come up with a good result, huh? So good luck.
Same pace at the back there. Keep running forward.
Mai nā mahi pāpāho, kua hoki anō nā kai tākoro ki te akoranga tuarua a te kaiako pukena a McBurn. Kua oti kē iaia nā mahi mō nā waiwai me nā ringa, kua huri inae nei ki te whakamahi i nā whatu.
We have to train our eyes to accept the threat. We've seen it with that. Okay, I'm looking at you now and I'm seeing Jim just wander over there with his head down. Okay, he's ready to get outside. And that's perfect. I didn't look at Jim to do that. What happens though in a game, we see something and we see it with the corner of our eye. We see it, it's the very thing we see, but we just have a bit of a look to make sure. We're okay with that. So we're going to go out there now and we're going to challenge this part of our vision, okay, to stay focused somewhere and accept what's going on around us and develop those muscles. And my job,
to stay in line with you two. Hei āwhina i nā kaitākoro kite kite i nā mea i nā tahataha. Ka whakahaere hia e Mick he mahinga e whakapakari ai i tēnei. Me urupare nā kaitākoro ki nā mea kei nā tahataha, engari me anga tonu atu te te tiro ki te kaitākoro i mua i a rātau i nā wā katoa.
Oh, it's a marvellous tool within the human body. It's designed to keep us alive by making us aware of what's going on around us. When we are under threat, it focuses very quickly on that threat. And by doing that, it allows us to then focus on the things that we need to do and make necessary decisions. And that can happen to us in a rugby environment. The threat might be a player rushing out of the line. What we need to do is develop the smaller muscles around the outside of the eye and develop that reaction time through our peripheral vision. What we need to do is learn to accept and react to that peripheral vision because it's no different to the vision we see if we look at it. So we just, if we can give our players activities that challenge them, their peripheral vision to read and react off their peripheral vision while maintaining a focus on something else, that will develop that the little muscles around the eye and develop the reaction and messages to the brain.
Green. Ko tētahi mea I puta mai tōna kōrero a tōna akonga o McBurn. Ko te titiro ki ngā hōriri, ki ngā kaitākoro, ki te taho i a koe, i mui a koe, i muri hoki. Ko tērā te mea nui, mena ka ako tērā paiana, tino paiana koe I runga I te whira. No te mea paiana koe ki te titiro ki ngā kaitākoro, ngā hōriri, e oma ana, e tutuki aia I a koe. Ki oku nei tūranga ke te pirangi koe kia te tiro hori I roto I ngā tūranga katoa kia mohi o ai te mahinga. Kia tika te kōrero ki o hua. Kia tika te pai te pōro, te pana I te pōro a hua. E ha te mahi, he tino waru tērā mō tōki tūranga.
Green. Green. You see what we're trying to get out of it. Yellow. We're trying to read and react. Green. We're trying to see things and react to what we see peripherally. Green. All right, without having to focus on it. We saw the guy move out the back, he moved from the green to the yellow. How many of us felt our eyes trying to drift to the yellow to see him when he moved? Okay, instead of just staying there, saw him move to the yellow, got him covered, he's done, knocked off, I move on. Same concept when I come around the corner and I see the outside defender shift in. I don't need to see that again. I've seen it. It's come in. I just need to offload. I don't need to look at it. We're okay with that. I see a come around the corner and I see a guy flying up and rush defence. I don't need to look at him. I've seen him. I just need to step a bit to the side. We're okay with that. So I need to react to what I'm seeing peripherally. I don't need to focus on it to make sure, to double check myself, to clarify, yep, he's actually coming. Because guess what happens to me when I look at him and see him coming? It's too late.
Ko te wāhanga e whai ake hei whakapakari I a rātou anō. Me hanga he kōrero mo te 2 meneti me te kauhau atu ki ngā tānata katoa o te kura nei I te pō I mua o te tākoro whakamutuna. I roto I ngā haora 24, ka tākoro tahi ai ngā tama nei mo te wā whakamutuna. He maha ngā mea kua tutuki tahi ā rātou, ka mutu kwei nei te wā e whai wāhi ai rātou, ki te whakaputa I o rātou whakaaro mo tēnei I roto I te 2 meneti.
Kia ora boys, you know, name my name, I'm Hariki Henry. Just like to start with a Māori kōrua nei. Whai o te pai tawhiti, kia tata whakamau o te pai tata, kia tīna. Strive for your long-term goals so that they can become attainable once they're on your sight, take gasp. My wonderful experience on Irans. It all started on a sunny Sunday afternoon when I arrived at Irans and I was so stunned witnessing the wonderful facilities the Institute has to offer all the athletes. I arrived with 3 important goals. 1, to specialise in my position. 2, to learn the best from the advisors. And 3, to improve my rugby on and off the field. Sino a whina nunui, e ra mahi, ngā kai whakahaere, ngā kai kōrero I mua I a mātou, I roto I tēnei wānanga, no te mea kua whakarongo mātou ki ora rātou kōrero, kua kaha o rātou mahinga, kia tū ai mātou I runga I te, kia tū ai, kia kōrero ki ngā tama. Ko te mea nui, whakarongo mātou kia Dave Hadfield, kia Rachel Rau, me e rātu kai whakahaere ai, he pai rau atu o rātou kōrero, ko te mea nui, ki whakarongo ai, kia mōhia ai o ki kōrero, ai, kia tūkaha, kia manawa nui. Irans has given me a head start into the life, dream and aspirations of becoming the best I can be. We have had great opportunities to rub shoulders with the best specialists and specific coaches, and also great speakers in the world, and that doesn't happen every day.
Yesterday we talked about emotions, and I think some emotions come out in the night hearing some speeches. Tūroa, he had a classic, it was great. I think he took the roof off the building in there.
Fitness testing, mental toughness, skills testing, mean sandwiches, contact continuity, mental toughness, legal log running, recovery, mental toughness, hāngis, defence, Richard Loom, Māori TV, leadership, mental toughness, mean ass sandwiches, kicking skills, lineouts, Steve Hansen, visions and handling, and of course, mental toughness. From the mean ass feeds to the Tūmeke coaches, the RN's experience has been me, Māori mean.
Tōku whakaaro I te timatanga ki te kōrero. Tōku whai kōrero te katoa I roto I te mereo Māori. I te tonu ki te tangata no Chile. Engari ka tuhituhi ana au etahi mea ara mai tērā ka mahi ana au tōku kōrero. Titiro ana hoki tōku au ki tōku hoa. Tuhituhi ona kōrero.
When I leave this place, memories will forever be bestowed within my mind, such as bombing in the recovery pool with Harry and Tinga, and later realising that you shouldn't put your head under. But hey, Māori's got a bomb. And munching the meanest feeds ever every day and not having to do the dishes. Man. But yeah, thanks for sending me here. Stop laughing, bro. Just send me here and just to learn off all the expertise that has been offered here. And hopefully I haven't stuffed it up for the boys next year. But sweet. Cheers.
Any good rugby player, you'll see them have interviews and stuff like that. Shows a bit of leadership skills, being able to say what's happened or address people when they need to. So yeah, I think it's another chance to show some leadership.
First of all, I'd like to start by thanking Steve, Renz and Murray for your encouraging words last year in August. Without the support of you guys, I don't think my experience here at Irons would have happened. So my greatest gratitude goes to you guys. Secondly, I'd like to show the greatest appreciation to Māori TV. Without that scholarship that you awarded me, I don't think I would have got here. It was a big gesture from you, and I hope that I've done you guys the pleasure of doing you proud. To Ariki and Tūroria, ngā mihi nunui ki a kōrua. I'm sure you boys have had the awesome experience that I have, and I'm proud to be alongside you boys with the scholarship.
Yeah, just have to get up there and talk for 2 minutes, which is pretty easy. Just needed to thank all the people I needed to thank, and yeah, I think I got that across, which was pretty good.
The email of success is due to my family, who I couldn't have done it without. My iwi, Ngāti Raukawa, the support of my hapū, Ngāti Pare, my college, Otaki College, who I played first 15 for, my union, Hora Whenua Kāpiti, and my community. I'm privileged to be here representing them all, and I hope I've done them proud. To all the boys in the room, my teammates, you guys have made my experience here at Irons extra special. It's an honour to be playing alongside you boys. Can't wait for tomorrow. I'm sure I'm going to be seeing you guys in the big time soon. Nā reira, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa.
Ka whakaū ngā kōrero I tēnā kaunui o ngā tama nei ki te eke a rōpū ki te taumata. Ko te whakātūrana I te toa o tēnei rōpū ka kitea, I roto I te tākoro whakamutuna a pōpō. Whakamutuna I te kura whakanunu whutupōro toa o te ao. Ko te tākoro kia Wairarapa Bush, te taumata o ngā mahi, ka tutuki I roto I te toru wiki. Toru wiki ki muri, ko te tākoro piu anahe te mea e tāia e rātou te mahi nātahi. I tau a wā, I tau o rātou whakaaro kia noho. Tō rātou tīma te mea toa katoa o ngā tīma katoa o Irans. Koenei te whakamātautau whakamutuna, ko tēnei tākoro hei whakātu atu I te toa o rātou pukena mo te hutupōro.
Boys' attitude as a group has been fantastic. And yeah, I've had a lot of specialists come in and you know, their heads are probably swimming a bit in the first couple of weeks, but we've had time to really enforce pattern and structures and you know, we've got some good leaders out there, so we should be able to put that on the park.
We're well prepared. You know, we've spent a lot of time in what we want to do and what we want to achieve. You can see how tight the boys are in the camp and how focused they are. You don't see boys running around on the field, kicking balls around. Everyone's relaxing and focusing on what they got to do. So, you know, I think all the boys are in the right frame of mind. And definitely one more big hurdle and just hopefully we can get out there and do what we want to do and come away with what we want to achieve.
Ai, ko tēnei te kēmi whakamutunga o tēnei wānanga mō mātou. Ko tēnei te tino e ki te whakamātautau mō tō mātou tīma. Engari, tino pai ana ngā te titiro o te tīma I tēnei wā. Tai ana mātou ki te titiro ki o mātou hoa, mōhio ana mātou te haraina e omana I aia. Kei hea ia I runga I te whira, mena ka pahiana te pōro ki aia, mena ka haere ki te whenua.
I'm pretty nervous today because Whitehaven Bush is a good team, and there's some other opportunities here. Like Dave, seeing as Dave Rennie is the coach and I'm moving up to Manawatu 2 this year, there's a chance to impress here. Bit anxious, but I'm also excited. You know, can't wait to get on the field and just go for it rather than last time thinking too much about what to do. Just go out there and play the game. So I'm looking forward to it, yeah.
Bit of pride, I guess. You know, they're a pretty tight group now. They've had 2.5 weeks together, and you know, they call each other brothers. We've heard that a lot, so that's very common for a group of guys who are thrown together. And you know, they've been put under pressure at various times, and they've been living in each other's pockets. So they're a tight group, and I think just for that reason alone, they want to play well for each other. It's the last time that these guys will be together as a group, and maybe last chance to perform. So yeah, I'd expect that they'll play for each other.
He ahua rere ke te wairua mo ngā whakatikatika mo te tākaro nui whakamutuna. Kei te ahua manawa pā nā kai tākaro, ia rātou e whakariri ana. Nā te kore mōhio pea ko wai kei roto i te tūmatuatahi e tai ā te ana nā tama nei. Me te aha, kaore anō kia whakaingoahia e nā kaiako ko wai ka eke tuatahi.
Martin, I think, Martin and Tom are sort of two different playing sort of styles, yeah. And that set it. And we started with Tom in their first game.
Oh, I think Martin deserves a start anyway. There's not a hell of a lot between them. Tom's probably a bit more accurate at the breakdown, and Martin is a better skilled distributor and link. So yeah, there's things that both those guys to focus on. But Martin has started from the bench last time, so it'd be good for him to prepare to start the game. There's a bit of competition in the midfield. We're starting with Araki, and pretty happy with the direction he's moving in. Similar to Roy, he's probably not quite fit enough for the position that he plays, but he's got a reasonably good skill set. He's been training well, and yeah, defensively, I'm looking forward to seeing him defensively, to be honest, because
we tested him that last game.
Yeah, and he ran a lot of outside shoulder stuff and got steep in the size. He ends up being a bit of a grab. So looking forward to seeing him be a little bit more physical. But Roy's the interesting one, isn't it? Because after knowing, having a chat with him, and after getting a fair bit of feedback on the computers, he was a different guy at training, and he's been very physical. Yeah. And his work rate's superb, etc. So, you know, we need to see that on the field for a minimum of 40 minutes.
I te wehenga rua o tēnei kura, haukerekere hiāna e Irans te Tīma Academy o Manawatu Turbos. Engari, he rereke te tīma o Wairarapa Bush. Inā rā, he taumata ke atu rātou.
Obviously, they're Heartland champions. They'll be a little bit older than our boys and a little bit more experienced, and so that's going to be a challenge. But they wouldn't have had an enormous amount of time together either, so yeah, it would certainly be a far bigger challenge than the first game.
Tangata nunui rātou. He kaha rātou, he riri, ki te mea, ki te pirangi rātou kia mau te pōro, ki Wanganui te whira, kia kau e hohonu, kia kau e haere ki ngā taha. Ko era o rātou mahi roto i te kēmu e pirangi ana rātou, ko ngā mea e pirangi ana mātou kia eke ki ngā taha, kia tere te haere te kēmu, kia tere te omo mātou parirau. I kia whiwhi ngā piro.
Doctors are running the toy, yeah. And the nurses are supporting for the bang line and the black ball.
We've got like some pace and some great skills, so should be a good match, but I think we've got a good chance, actually.
Hopefully we've got superior continuity and fitness, and we're pretty keen to play a wide game. We don't want to be too confrontational, especially if they're a bit older and bigger. So we want to move the point of attack pretty quickly, so a bit of a ruck and run game, really. So there should be a lot of ball movement, and the conditions look like they'll be right, so we want to play it pretty fast.
What I can't stress enough is how we prepare this afternoon. So I mentioned to some guys, don't want to see people playing table tennis and pool this afternoon. Get off your feet, relax, so you've got plenty of energy for this afternoon. Eat well, drink well, so and so on.
Ka tahi anō nā tama nei ka whiwhi wā pēnei te nui ki te mahi ā rātou ake mahi. Ko tētahi mahi pai hei mahi tēnei wā, ko te haere ki te kite i te kai kōmiri.
I te tīmatanga o tēnei wānanga i a rōpū ai mātou, i kōrero ai. Ko tērā tētahi o ngā whāinga tūmanako kia toai mātou kia eke ki te taumata o ngā taumata katoa i roto i tēnei wānanga o Irans. Kia tū ai mātou tēnei rōpū, he rangatira mō ngā tau e heke mai nei ki te ai rātou. Tēnei te tīma pairau atu i Irans, ai kia pirangi rātou kia eke ki te taumata e tū mai mātou.
From our point of view, it's just exciting to see them play, you know. We're just really keen for them to play well and do justice for themselves, so that's what it's about in the end, I think.
I te wā e whakahaere ana rātou, ia rātou whakanekeneke, whakamutuna mo te tākoro, māra māna te kite o te hikiaki o te ihi me te wehi ki tētahi taumata anō.
Definitely a bit nervous because I've got a bit of family coming from Wellington to watch. Yeah, I want to go on the track and put a big performance on and hopefully, my family members can stand on the sideline and be proud of what I'm doing out there.
Ka tai mai anō te whānau o mātenga ki te mātakitaki āia.
Well, they're the ones who put heaps of effort into me, eh? I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for them or the support they've given me. So, I'd love them to come watch so I can show them my appreciation to them, give it back to them by the way I play.
We were organised for a couple of phases and the rest is playing what's in front of us. And so it's going to be a lot about working hard off the ball and getting into position and getting into space and then having the skills to get the ball there. So. If we can manage all those sort of things, it'll be pretty satisfying for everyone, I think.
Ah, kua tai mai te wā. Mai te tīmata tana ka uru tonu te tīma o Irans ki te whakatinana i te mahere ki te tuku atu i te pōro ki ngā parirau. Rere ana a mātenga ki te tukituki i ngā ketuketu. Rā kei te kitea te kaha o Ariki Iaia e o mato o tika ana. Kia kai ana te āhua o tūroia ki te kimi mahi. Anā wairā, nā tēnei ka pore ia ki raro. Tino hohi pera kēnei tēnā pāhi. Te tino pai o nā mahi a tūroia Iaia i Irans ki te whakapiki Iaia. A te āhua nei kua whara heahea noiho i tēnā pāhi. Aha kua pēhea, kaore e tāia te aha, kua mutu te wāhanga ki āia.
Oh, it's the ACL. Exact same thing I did to this leg.
It's the same, eh?
Yeah.
Always the same.
Feels the same.
Yeah, I'm down. Where are you from?
Tino Pauri, whakaaro i nānei, engari, mina ka mahi, te mahi, ka pai, engari, ai, he ahua Pauri, kāre pai, engari, ka mahi a ine mahi.
Kei te tīma o Irans te kaha i roto i tēnei tākoro, enari nā a rātou hapa e kore rātou e whaipiro. Nā wai, ka riro mā nā paumua e karawhiu. Ka kaha mai a Wairarapa Bush, enari autāia tonu a Irans ki te tāmi a rātou. Katahi ka puta te ihi kia Irans, rere tonu atu te pōro hei kōkiri mā nā paumuri tere. Kei runga a Irans i te wehenga rua, me te mahi nui a te kaiako ki te huna I tōna hari mo te pai o te tākaro o tana tīma.
Played into the breeze, and we're 13 up on the board, so end result pretty good. I just want to mention a few things. Our structure's been really good. You know, we've talked about using the ball wide from the kickoffs, and we've done that pretty effectively. It's what we do beyond that. We need to be smart. In that last play, we had no numbers back in the middle of the field. They had one guy defending the blind side, but we still came back this way. What it comes down to, other than that, guys, is accuracy. We just haven't been accurate enough, and that's what's put us under pressure.
So we just got to be patient, hey? Like, winning our line-out ball. All right, so if we get those penalties, let's just move it down there, suck it up, get them back in, and then we can move the ball wide.
Midfield change, so Harry and Dave come in the midfield. Jack, you're going to fullback.
Lucas, you're on for Justin. Tom, you're on for Martinga.
Hoi o ka whakaro mo tēnei kēmua. Haere au ki waho rā mahi tōku mahi. Ai, mau te pōro tino pai. Ki omoa ki mua. Ai, ahua, pau te ahau I nāinei. Get to
I think I was a lot more comfortable in this game, you know, rather than trying to get too much in my mind about everything, you know, just concentrated on my job and concentrated on my own game rather than what everybody's trying to tell me to do, eh?
Certainly a big difference within a week. That's really noticeable. And just genuinely seeing his enjoyment for the game out there on the field today was really good to see.
Oh, tino riri e rā tangata ke te kurei tākuro mātou. He nui rātou, ke te he pai o rātou e ki ana te teku. Pai rau atu ki a rātou, ko te mea nui tākuro mātou, tō mātou a pūkenga ai.
Ka roa haere ana te tākaro, ka pai ake te tākaro o ngā tama o Irans, a māma ana te kite atu I te toa me te māia o enei taitama. Ahakoa I uaua I te wāhanga tuatahi, taira wātu ki te otina o te wāhanga tuarua, he puehu noaiho te kai a te tīma o te Wairarapa. Kua puta nā ihu o nā pia o Irans. Toru te kau te wikitoria kia te Wairarapa me te ārai atu anō I ā rātou mai te rai nā piro. Engari, katau mai te pauri ki runga I a rātou. Ina, kaore rātou e hui tahi, e tākoro tahi anō, mai I tēnei rā haere ake nei, kua whai rātou I o rātou ake huarahi.
Pretty happy with the way the boys went. You know, obviously, it's always going to be tough for Warrior Bush. They had one training run, and well, they had some experienced players on there. They also had a mixture of young fellas coming through. Advantage of living together for 3 weeks, you know, we drip feed a lot of things initially and we have a lot of time to work on basic structures and stuff, so yeah, some of the stuff we did very well, there was lots of opportunities that we didn't take, but you know, a normal coaching scenario, you'd have a few more weeks to keep working on that. But.
This morning when we woke up and put the Juice TV on the TV, and there's some sad songs playing, so there's a few tears in the boys' eyes, you know, they're getting a bit upset about everybody leaving, but nah, it's been a good experience. Everybody's just made heaps more mates, eh? Even overseas, if you're travelling, you know, you can always look at your contacts list and say, you know, I know this guy. So there's heaps of things that have come out of it, but it'll be sad to leave here.
Life-changing experience, I guess.
lent all the attributes you need to become a professional rugby player. And yeah, it's, you know, emotions are sad but happy at the same time because you go back and get to see your whānau again, and I guess, you know, that's the best thing about life, is nothing's better than home.
Yeah, it's pretty frustrating and pretty sad at the same time, but I just look at it as another learning curve, I suppose. You know, these things happen, and whatever, you know, whatever steps you take from now on really determines, you know, how you go in your future. But yeah, frustrated and disappointed, but yeah, it happens, I suppose.
I see a lot of hard work for all three of them. You know, obviously, Roy's really picked things up in regard to his attitude, and obviously that injuries could be quite serious, so that may limit, well, the unfortunate thing is it's going to limit what he can do. Hopefully the idea was that he goes back and he's now bred a few good habits and he builds on that over the next few months, but this injury's going to obviously slow him down a bit. But you know, he's, his attitude's really improved. Once he's fit, he's going to be a hell of a lot better player. He's certainly got a lot of skills and that sort of thing, so there's a bit of hard work to be done for him, obviously. A bit of recuperation and obviously getting that fitness going for him.
Ko te mea nui, e rapu ana au mai tēnei wānanga, ki te ana i ngā eki, ngā professionals, e mahi ana, i a rātou āo eki, i a rā, āho rereke ana roku whakaro i nāinei ki i mō i tēnei wānanga. Tērā tētahi mea nui, ko tētahi anō ko te whanaungatanga, te whānautanga e ki o te tātou tētahi ki tētahi e oku hoa. Tōku pirangi e kore e ngaro wera whanaungatanga, wera āhuatanga o mātou.
Fitness testing, mental toughness, skills testing, mean sandwiches, contact continuity, mental toughness, legal log running, recovery, mental toughness.
Roy's a real hard case, you know, and he's one of the team clowns and really enjoys being around other people and that sort of thing. He was really good for team spirit, you know, he had the boys laughing a lot, etc. So, you know, I think his personality, you need those sort of personalities within a team, you know, team culture.
I suppose even when I can't play rugby, it'll still have the passion in that. Just, it's just another, I suppose, you know, another fork in the road on the way there. But yeah, nah, the fire still burns.
I feel like I've learned so much. I just want to keep going, eh? Like, I've got the tools, and now I just need to use them, really. So I'm just really anxious to go and play some more games for my number two and things like that.
Martinho is obviously going to put on some size. He's very skilled, you know, he's a very good link, etc. And so most of his work's going to be in that contact area. And, but he's a good kid, and he's got a really good attitude, so I'm pretty confident that he won't have any problems in that area.
Actually, leaving for a training camp tomorrow for the Manawatu Academy, so that should be quite fun. Got a few games for them and looking for a club up here, had a few offers, and yeah, just try to do really well up here so I can make an impression on the Turbos.
So I've seen Martinho grow in confidence. You know, like, obviously I knew a bit about him. He's played against us a couple of times on our student courses, and he's been the opposition captain, and we're really impressed with him. And we obviously encouraged him to try and get on one of these courses. He's a very confident, excellent speaker, and led the boys really well on the field. So when he came to this course, it was, I suppose you don't really think about it so much, but he's obviously young compared to most of the boys, and I think once he got to know the boys a lot better, he grew in confidence, and so that's been really good for him, I think.
My personal goal was just to soak up all the information, just listen to everything, and just be a real team player, and it's really worked because the information I've soaked up, I've used on the field, come away with a better game, which is really good. I feel I come away a better person from this, actually, like, not just as a rugby player, but just a person in general. When I came here, I had expectations of, you know, it being quite hard and things like that, but it was quite hard, but at the same time, it was a really good feeling, you know, knowing that you're learning so much, and Yeah, it's been really good.
I come on this course for three specific goals, and one was to specialise in my position, two was learn from the best, and my third one was to enjoy and treasure, you know, this course. And yeah, I've definitely achieved all those three goals. Didn't really know much about a midfield rugby player, but you know, coming to this course has just given me a head start into the life of a midfield rugby player, and you know, very pleasing to have been taught from the best, Frank Bunsen, and it's just, you know, great treasure that I need to hold and fulfill in my aspirations in rugby.
Arakia, and we've often talked about his fitness too. He's even saw yesterday. He worked really hard, and but he does tire. And but he's got a lot of skill, and I've really enjoyed working with him as well. If he gets fitter, he's going to be such a better player. And so that's going to be a focus for him, really. But you know, they've all got little things that have been given from their specialists, and so they'll be well aware of areas they need to be focusing on. But you know, it's like with a lot of guys who've come through this course, just important what they do once they leave, you know.
Tuatai ka hoki au ki te kāinga, ngā rā whakatai e ke moine, ka moe kore au, ka aha moe roa, mo ngā rā e rua e pia, i muri e tēnā, ka o mahau, ka mahi oku mahi kia tūai, hei rangatiro mō a pōpō pia, ko te mea nui, kia oti oku a tuhitui i roto tōku pukupuka, kia kite ai oku kai i a rā i a rā, oku omoma, me e ratu mea ai, ko te mea nui, me mahi o nā mahi. Kia kau e rite tonu au i mua i tēnei i a wānanga, ko te mea me eke au te rō mā taimata.
You see a group of, you know, 28 players. They start out with no one really knowing anyone, and you know, they're all pretty quiet. The dining room's fairly quiet in the first day or so, but you know, once they mix in and start working hard together, you know, they all grow as a group. So it's been really good.
We may not be the best. There's no way of telling that, but definitely we should be one of the best that's come through. That's a good feeling to be a part of that, because it took all 28 guys to come up with that sort of mix in the group, and like Murray said, there's quite a balance. So yeah, it's not individuals, it's their whole group, and everybody's played their part in it.
No, it's funny, isn't it? You know, I mean, they've been a great bunch to work with. We sort of commented with the first skills session we had that as a group they looked a lot slicker than anything we'd had. Normally you get a handful of guys who really battle, and they improve as the course goes on, but these guys looked a little bit slicker. You know, whether they're the best team or not, I mean, I don't know. They're certainly probably got the best results, and there's some very good players who have probably got big futures, hopefully. So yeah, they're certainly one of the best groups. How's that?
Te mando.